Hi, Pastor Bill, Bethel Lutheran Church, and it is Saturday, the 6th of June. Hoping that our online gathering finds you doing well. We open with prayer. Lord, on this day we jump into all that you've given us. Let us embrace each part of this glorious time, enjoying the service we give to other people, relishing in the challenges, engaging with the fun, and celebrating with laughter. Lord, on this day, may we enjoy the beauty of the created world all around us. May we run, drive, walk, and sing in the freedom of this day. Thank you that right now we can feel your love flowing through each vein of our being, causing us to pulsate with vision and life, which is through your Spirit alone. Amen. Our reading is from the book of John, the 14th chapter, verses 15 through 17. Jesus is speaking. If you love me, show it by doing what I've told you. I will talk to the Father, and he'll provide you another friend, so that you will always have someone with you. This friend is the Spirit of Truth. Godless world can't take him in, because it doesn't have eyes to see him, doesn't know what to look for. But you know him already because he has been staying with you and will even be in you. Here ends our reading. I believe it was yesterday we were talking about trust and the dynamic of trust and how that relationship between God and us, enabled with the Spirit, causes us to have faith, causes us to, there's the word again, entrust our lives to God. This particular reading, it's pretty simple and straightforward. Jesus is saying, you know, if you love me, you'll show it by what you do. And that can be a pretty tough thing to crack, because when we talk about, well, if I love God, I'll do what God wants me to do, we don't always do a good job of that. We know in our hearts, you know, Luther wrote, the law is written on our hearts. And we know what the law tells us to do, what we need to be doing, and what we shouldn't be doing. We're very familiar with that. But carrying that through is another story. And that is a sign of the law showing us our sinfulness and where we fall short. But Jesus says to us, my love is with you. God's love is with you always. And because of that, we should show response. We should show what our response is to God, because what God first did for us. Jesus' words are very simple. I'll talk to the Father. He'll provide you with someone besides me. After Jesus is gone, the Spirit is provided. And it's that same Spirit that draws us together, that brings us together as one people in Christ, that helps us to understand that as Christians, no matter what congregation we belong to, what parish we're part of, we all are part of the body of Christ. And that's what binds us together. That's what brings us together in our baptisms. That's what creates us to be the people of Jesus. The godless world can't take him in because it doesn't have eyes to see him, doesn't know what to look for. But you know what to look for. We, in each of our baptisms, we know what to look for because the Spirit dwells within us. May this same Spirit guide you today and forever, according to Jesus' will. Amen. We close with prayer. And Lord, on this day, we would take time to remember. It's the 6th of June, and it sometimes gets lost in history. But it is a day that we remember there were some very, very young men. Boys, so many of them just out of high school, who were ready to give their all on D-Day. It was on that day in World War II that the hope and promise of the youth of this country and other countries brought down tyranny. And it's that same sense of offering self that we remember the many who gave their all that we might have freedom. We hallow their memories. And we thank those, the survivors, who braved the danger, who became our ancestors. We thank them, dear Lord, and we thank them for being examples for us. Gather us now and together. Make us your people. Make us willing to serve always. For it is in your name that we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the path of the Spirit be your path, now and always. Amen.
Things for the way they really are. Open our eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you.
Lift it up, let me hear you.
Power and love, 'cause we sing holy, holy.
Holy.